Alright, today I have a magnetostriction oscillator. These were popular back in the, I think the first patent was 1921, and I've seen it referenced a lot in older books when tubes were popular. And this circuit uses a transistor instead of a tube, and the rest of it's pretty much the same. You have two coils, two magnets. I've inserted a piezo here. That is in order to sort of detect any pressure change or expansion along the axis of the rod. These are the details of the circuit. The coils, I'm not sure I've connected them, but I mean there are only two ways to connect them. One of the keys to the circuit is you need to limit the base current, otherwise, if you want to achieve a resonant frequency, because otherwise the base will get triggered very easily and you won't reach a resonant frequency as easily. I can show that as well just by shorting out R1, which I will do. But first, we'll look at the collector voltage. It's going from 12 to 0 at that rate. One other thing that you can do, and that was done back in the day, was putting a capacitor parallel with that inductor shown here. And what that would do is sort of create a resonance. I think in this configuration it might not work, but if you had a high side FET and a you had a high side FET configuration or something like that, it would allow that oscillation to occur sort of better. I don't know if you need an NFET or a JFET. Okay. So, right now it's oscillating at 36.5 kHz. That is the collector voltage. Next I'm going to show the piezo voltage. Across the piezo, you will see a sine wave at this frequency. Assuming we can get this to focus. Alright, this is again at 36.5 kHz. As I slide one of the coils inward, we're going to lose the resonance, and the expansion and contraction of the rod is no longer sinusoidal. And the other way we can make that failure occur is by removing one of the magnets. The bias magnet is really the key to the magnetostriction effect in this situation. As I lift that magnet, we lose the resonance as well. If I reverse the direction of the magnet, we lose the resonance. You really need to have the magnets in attract mode so all the flux is flowing in one direction. The other thing we can do, like I promised, is shorting out the base coil or base resistor. As soon as I do that, all bets are off. It's just gonna make a nice audio generator, probably pretty stable, but not what we want. If you do go slowly, it'll be pretty continuous, but when you have the resistor in, it latches onto different modes, different oscillation modes. Okay, last thing to show is squeezing the rod at different locations, and we'll see when we squeeze the very center, it has the most effect at this resonant frequency of 36 kHz. Also, like the oscillations have stopped here. In order to start the oscillations, you actually have to do that, and they come back. All right, so we'll just go ahead and leave the collector voltage and the piezo voltage showing as I squeeze this rod. I'll start at the end, squeeze, I'm getting towards the center. And as I get towards the center, it actually has an effect of pretty much killing the oscillation. I go back towards the end and it doesn't have the effect, but right at the middle, it's just like a fulcrum and a swing and a teeter-totter. It just, well, it kills that oscillation. that's all I have to show. If you have any questions, let me know, and I'd love to see it if you try to build the circuit. It'd be pretty interesting. Show the setup one more time.